Hey y'all, Kentucky Farmer here, and today we are back on the Westbridge Hills map in my test game for my 18th video about Courseplay. In this video, I'm going to show you how to harvest and transport chaff to the BGA. Everything in this video has been covered individually in previous videos, so in this video, things will be moving at a little bit quicker pace. If you're new to Courseplay and you missed the first 17 videos, you might want to go back and start from the beginning. There's a link in the description below to my Courseplay tutorial playlist. So to get started, we want to fire up our tractor here. And we're going to bring up Courseplay. Now, when I set up the first thing I'm going to do here is set up the route that the tippers are going to use to take the chaff back to the BGA. And the route that I'm going to set up, I'm sure some of you are going to think is excessively long for where this field's at. So we're doing field 21, and the biogas plant's right here. But I like setting up the routes like this for two reasons. We're gonna start harvesting this field from this side, and the harvester will work its way north. So I want to start and end my route down here. That way the tractors and the tippers will be driving through the harvested section of the field, and you won't have them driving through the crop. And then I'm also going to set up the course so that we're going to start up here, and we're going to come around like this. We'll go to the BGA, and then we're going to come back down here. So you're basically making a loop, so you don't have to worry about your tractors getting in traffic with each other. Now, this road here does have AI traffic in this map, so we'll have to make sure that we, you know, hold a good lane position here so that we don't get into the AI traffic. In theory, we could drive through the grass, but I'll drive on the road like you're supposed to, and odds are, while filming this video, we'll have maybe one or two tractors that'll have an issue with the traffic, but for the most part, Courseplay is pretty good about detecting the cars and slowing down so that it doesn't wind up getting stuck with them. So, let's go up here and I'll start recording this course. I like to start as close as I can to the end. Like, you could start recording the course here, but if you had a tractor make it all the way down to the end here when it was full, it would then have to drive back to that starting point and then back down here, so it just seems make a little more sense if we start down here. So we'll start course recording. And then I'm going to kind of swing out this way, and we'll even drive on these rocks a little bit. That way, if there's a harvester making a turn down there, it's a little bit less likely that someone here driving will get in the way. And then we're going to kind of merge into that traffic like this. Kind of wish there was a way that you could make the AI traffic drive faster. Now here's one of the other things that I do that's a little different. I only like having one offload course from the field to the BGA. So what I do is once I get here, I'll actually drive up and down every bunker. And I always start with that one that's closest to the hopper, because that's my favorite one to fill. But then by driving up and down every one, the Courseplay will automatically start filling the first one, and then if the first one's full or if the first one has silage in it, or if the first one has the cover on it, right, it'll still drive over it, but then it will dump in the next one, and if the next one's full, it dumps in the next one. So by setting the course up like this, you can have one course that would fill all four, starting from the left and working its way right. And then once I drive through all those, I just drive out of the BGA and continue on my loop. And here I like coming up far enough that if I had two or three tractors waiting, there's enough room behind us that the if you had a harvester trying to turn at the edge of the field, it wouldn't be getting in the way of these tractors. So this is far enough. We'll go ahead and stop recording, and then I'm gonna save this as offload BGA. And then let's see here, do I have a field 21? No. So now we got field 21, offload BGA. Alright, so then for our next step, we're going to back this guy up a little bit. Because these, if you remember, they start at the last point. They don't actually start at the first point. So we're going to go in here, and we want to set this into combi mode. Because it's going to drive out into the field, empty the harvester, and then once it's full, continue on its route. So that's combi mode. Now, the next thing we're going to do, so with Courseplay and with combi mode, I think the same thing applies for overloader mode. It has the ability to automatically search for the combine. In order for that to work, both pieces of equipment, the harvester and the tractor, need to be inside the field. So they got to be in this dirt texture here. Because our course isn't in the field, it's next to the field. And with chaff harvesters, when they start, he'll be in the field, but he'll just barely be in the field. So I find it's just better with chaff harvesters if you don't rely on the automatic search and we manually select that we want the FR850, which is the chaff harvester that we're going to use 85 meters away. And then we're going to do a couple more settings while we're here, and we'll have to do the same setting for all four of our tractors. So our side offset, we leave it auto, but our vertical offset, we're actually going to do auto minus 8 meters. I do this because if you don't pull the tractor back a little bit, sometimes on a turn, a sharp right or a sharp left turn, and the tractor's on the right hand side, it can come around and kind of get in front of the harvester's head, and it'll cause them to get stuck in traffic. And so really with your side offset, your vertical offset, and your operating speeds, it's totally dependent on what you're using. So here I'm using all four are the same, but they're New Holland T8s with 1,000 kg weight on the front and 600 kg weight, no, is that 700 kg weight on the back? The reason why I have the weight on the back is because these smaller Flegal trailers have a mid-hitch, and the New Holland T8s don't have a mid-hitch. So if you put the weight on there, see they've got that low hitch, but they don't have a mid-hitch. So by putting the weight on there, you can actually connect the trailer up to it. Now this has the added benefit of, as all these drive over the silo, you have all that weight that helps compact the silage as each one goes in and dumps. So It won't be fully compacted when we get done, but it'll be pretty far along. Now, I'm also using smaller trailers just because the way I have it snake through the silos, it's easier for this tractor to make those turns and to snake through there. And if one was covered or full, it's easier for this. I mean, that's a lot of tractor for this little trailer. So even when it's full of chaff, it's easy for it to make it up and down over that stuff. So I found this just a more nimble, it's a more nimble setup to do it this way. And then what I lack in capacity in the trailer, I make up for by the fact that I've got four trailers that are going to be doing this operation. The expensive part of this is having the four tractors to pull them. But you got to remember, making silage at the BGA is like a license to print money in this game. So this field alone will probably make enough money at the BGA on easy or medium to pay for all the equipment that's sitting here. So it's just getting to the point in the game where you can buy this equipment to do it. So, all right, so we've got our offset and our turning circle. We leave that. Start at 50, drive on at 90. I'll talk about this one later, the start at. We'll leave it at 50. That's fine. Drive on at doesn't matter for this because we're offloading a chaff harvester, not a harvester combine. And then our speeds. It's the last thing we got to set up here. So we're going to do 6 mile an hour turn speed. We're going to crank our field speed up to 25 miles an hour. Again, that's the benefit of little trailer, big tractor. And our street speed, we are going to do maximum, but we're going to dial it down to 25. If you have this up at 31, you're just more likely to have issues with traffic or to have Courseplay overdrive a corner or something. Reversing speed 3 miles an hour, that's fine too. So that should be everything. Now, if I tell this to start from the nearest waypoint, it'll start from this one. It should drive up to that stop sign, sit there for a couple seconds, and then it will probably actually drive around and come behind the New Holland, even though it's not doing anything, which is good because that's what we need it to do in order for this to actually start harvesting the field. So let's go ahead and see if it works. Drive course. Now, he'll drive through the crop here. I try really hard to set up Courseplay so that it doesn't drive through the crop. I suppose I could have had the harvester closer or started him later or something, but sometimes Courseplay just really wants to drive through the field. Alright, so there we go. So let's go ahead and we'll go get the harvester started. Well, actually, let me do the settings on all these. I won't start them, but I'll get them set up so that we can start them as soon as the harvester's going. So we're going to do field 21, offload BGA. We're going to do combine mode. Eight meters behind. Alright, so there's that one. If you notice, if you scroll up, it goes positive. If you scroll down, it goes negative. So positive means that it will automatically put the tipper under the spout plus a meter or back a meter. So I'm telling this to go back 8 meters because it keeps the harvester has the range to shoot into the trailer even though it's that far back behind it, and it keeps the tractor out of the way of the front of the harvester. Alright, so now everybody's set up. So let's hop into the harvester and get it set up. Looks like we may have to go rescue our tractor. I think he's stuck in traffic already. That's alright, let's get this guy rolling. So we're gonna do fieldwork mode, and then we're gonna do field 21 starting at the southwest corner heading east. And it's 9 meters wide. West, heading east. We're not going to return. We don't need a headland, so we'll go ahead and make that. And then we can turn this thing on. Alright. And tell it to start the first waypoint. Now, it's going to drive, like, I don't know, a meter or two into the field and then stop. So you waste a little bit of but not a lot. So there you go. Alright, so now we can go rescue this guy. I think if I move this one, that other tractor should be able to automatically start going. Nope, of course not. It's alright, we gotta get these guys moved anyways. So, here we go. We are making chaff. So you see, these guys are all gonna come over here and they're gonna sit at that stop point and wait. And what they're waiting for, this is what I wanted to point out earlier. So you see how this says start at 50%? When you are talking about an overloader and you're overloading a combine harvester, that means that it will go to the harvester and unload it when it's 50% full. And drive on at 90% means that if the harvester has finished offloading into you and has started to return to harvesting and you're just sitting in the field, if you're 90% or more, then drive on with your course and go empty. So when we're doing chaff, if you just noticed, I hit 53%. And that guy just started driving. So what this means is it's not when this guy's at 50% because he's either producing chaff or not. There's no percentage to it. It's the tractor that's currently being loaded. When it gets to 50%, it tells the next one to start. And this guy's just going to kind of hang out back here. And when we're full, he'll drive around the harvester and go down and start the offload course. And then this guy will come up behind the harvester and then take its place so that the harvester can keep going. So, I mean, really, we could probably turn this up to 70%, but when we've got the four tractors running, we should basically always have one that's being loaded, one that's getting ready to be loaded, one that's on the way to the BGA or unloading at the BGA, and one that's stopped here. And we'll kind of see how that works as we go. So, all right. So now, see, he's going to start his course, and this next one is coming in here, and this next one now is going to start filling up. And this guy's just going to wait here, and this one's still waiting here until they're needed. So by having these four tractors, I've got enough that they can all be out doing various parts of this loop, and we should always have one here at the harvester being filled so that the harvester only briefly stops for a few seconds while it's switching from one trailer to the other. Obviously, if we were to use the crone, which has a slightly bigger head, I think they all only do 6 miles an hour unless you have a modded one, but if we were using the crone, which has a little bit bigger head, it would fill these trailers a little bit faster. And, you know, if you're using a different field that was a different distance from the BGA, you may need, I mean, you could, if we had a closer field, you may only need three tractors. If we had a further away field or a harvester that was producing chaff faster, then you may need a fifth tractor trailer combination. So this guy's at 62, which means if we go check, the next guy should be, I'm not too sure why he's not driving yet. So he's at 50. Oh, he's on automatic search, that's why. There we go. So now he'll drive. Let's double check this guy. Alright, he's on manual. Okay. Good thing we checked that. Alright, and this guy is almost to the BGA, so we'll come watch him unload. So now, one of the nice things about Courseplay, we talked about this in the last video, he's going to slow down, and Courseplay like automatically figures out how big the silo is, how much chaff you have, and will basically go the right speed so that as it's unloading, it will evenly fill the entire silo, and you won't wind up with a big pile at the start or a big pile at the end. One thing I have noticed that's a little odd is sometimes it won't dump 100% of the chaff out of the trailer, and so by the time we're done, there's going to be a little bit of chaff in this silo too, even though the first one's not 100% full. But I guess that's just the another reason why it's good to have it drive up and down all these. So, I mean, as you can see, this is it takes time to do this, but as long as we've got enough equipment out running the course between that guy, this guy, and this guy. So again, we've got one waiting, one being filled, one driving to the BGA, and one that's at the BGA. And really, for the rest of the time, you'll almost never see two tractors sitting here waiting. This guy's, 42%, so we can actually watch it from here. He'll hit 50, and as soon as he hits 50, you'll see that tractor down there will start driving towards us, and that'll probably start driving before the next tractor that just unloaded at the BGA gets back. The other neat thing that you'll notice is that Courseplay does a good job automatically trying to keep these guys out of the crop. So when you look here, this is auto 7 meters. When he's coming the other direction, it's gonna say auto minus 7 meters because it wants it, instead of being, you know, if this is 0, he's 7 meters over, he'll be the other direction when he's coming back. That way the trailers are always over here in the harvested area and not driving through the corn. All right, so it looks like our tractor, our first one, just got back from the BGA. So, and this one's full, so now it's gonna drive out of here. And you can see how by putting the start point over here, it gets him to drive away from the harvester and then down here, so that one that was kind of following us is going to be up in the field and will be out of the way, and that way you don't have collisions between them while they're trying to come around to the harvester. Alright, so he's finished with his unloading. He's waiting. That's pretty much it. At this point, I'm just gonna fast forward the video, and this is probably going to take, you know, at least a half hour or 45 minutes to finish this field at the rate that they're going. Oh, this is another thing I want to show you. Notice how the tractor pulled out of the way, and then the combine gets back into the crop, and then the tractor comes around behind it. It Courseplay does that automatically to keep it from getting in the way of the harvester while the harvester's making its turn. So, and then the other thing I can do, I can show you the difference here with our offset. So you saw earlier where I scrolled this down to -8. If I dial this back up, you can see how the tractor moves forward, right? And so what would happen is if this makes a left turn, this tractor will make a left turn too. The problem is the tractor is so close to that header that if it turns in front of it, it will actually cause this to get stuck in traffic, and then because this isn't moving, the tractor won't move, and then they just sit there. So by dialing this back to -8, you can see it drops back, and -8 puts it behind the header, right? So that way, if the harvester makes a turn and the tractor goes to turn, there's no way that the tractor can get in front of the harvester. We can adjust the side offset. Like here, if I dial it down, he'll get closer. And you can even... Oh, well, he's full, so... Let's put this thing back the way it's supposed to be. We'll go look at the next one. So, we could... dial this guy back a little bit more. And then we can go over, and you kind of get like behind, right? You can do that too. If you're too close, this tractor will sense the header as traffic and will stop moving. So let's get this back over here. See there, he got traffic for a second. So let's get this back to 7 and this guy back to 8. There you go. I just find that this is the best. Again, this is kind of the automatic setting. This one is the only one that I really ever change. And like I said earlier, you just have to kind of play with these because it totally depends on the harvester, the tractor, and the trailer that you're using, what you need to set this to. So. All right, well, like I was saying earlier, at this point, it's a whole lot of the exact same thing as we go through the field. So since this will take a half hour to 40 minutes for us to work all the way through it, I'm going to fast forward it, and I'll probably actually get it up to at least 8 speed, if not faster. So I'm just going to hop into the harvester, and I'm just going to follow the harvester, and we'll zoom out and watch it go. So that's our last load of chaff. We'll follow this guy as he follows the route back to the BGA. That way we can take a look at our bunker and see how much chaff we wound up with. All right, so we've got just over 825,000 liters of chaff, and we're 62% compacted. So this is a lot of chaff, and once this is silage, that's gonna be a lot of money. It's relatively easy to get this all set up. In this video I followed the harvester, but really once you get them working, you can go do something else on the map while this is running relatively unattended. So that concludes the 18th video in my Courseplay series. In the next video in this series, I'll cover using Courseplay to run a wheel loader to automate selling silage at the BGA. If you're interested in trying out Courseplay, I'll put a link in the description below to the mod website. Hopefully you found this video useful. If you have any questions or comments, be sure to leave them below. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more like it, be sure to click the like button and subscribe for more Farming Simulator videos. I'm Kentucky Farmer, thanks for watching.